Welcome guys to the PowerShell series. In this series, we will try to get some hands-on on PowerShell. So let's start with a basic introduction. So PowerShell is a task automation and configuration management framework, basically from Microsoft. And it consists of a command line shell and the associated scripting language. Primarily it was on .NET framework and later they changed it to .NET Core, I think. Please don't ask the difference. I really don't know right now. So today we will see how we can change the text or you can say attribute of XML file using PowerShell. So XML stands for Extended Markup Language. At least I know something. So let's create an XML file first. So let's see. You have to give the XML version. Here I'm using 1.0. And then coding you have to give. And coding I'm using UTF-8. I hope you are familiar with this. So I'm creating a tag that says reports and and inside that let's create a report tag. Report, let's give it a name equal to testing test1 and ID equal to test1 and let's give a color attribute, color equal to, let's say red is not my favorite color, so yeah, please ignore that. Whatever is your favorite color, you can write it there, doesn't matter. So you can write another one while I'm writing again. Just copy it and copy it. Just change this to test2, test3, oh let's say test2 and test3, and same goes here. Red, yellow, green. None of these are my favorite colors, so please ignore that. Yeah. And to create XML file, just give your file name, let's say, and .xml extension, and that will create a XML file for you. Okay, the XML file has been created, and let's see the PowerShell now. So write PowerShell in your search. I misspelled that. PowerShell. Click on the application, PowerShell will open. I have already opened that. So there is an icon that says new script, click on that. And here you can write whatever you want. And here the blue screen that you are seeing here is the command line, you can say, where you can see the output. So let me show you the common basic string we have used. Okay. Or you can say we are using from our childhood, hello world. And you can see here, hello world has been printed. So what we will do with the PowerShell, we will change this XML file color attribute to something else. So let's say I have to change the color attribute of ID test equal to 3. So how will I will do that? So how will I will do that? Nice question. Yeah. So first of all, what I will do, I will declare the path where my file is stored. So any variable that you declare in PowerShell should start with a dollar symbol. Path. And it will be the place where the file is stored. So take it from here. Simple. Okay. So we know this is an XML file. So we will need to create a object basically. So I will create an XML object. So to create an object, write new object. And we are creating an XML object. Once the object has been created, we need to load the file in that object. So XML.load. So that says path. So the file has been loaded. The path contains the file. And the file, we have loaded the file in this XML variable. Basically, that's a XML object. So, okay. So now we have to work with this ID test equal to 3. So we need to figure out a way how we can locate this. So for that, there's a particular function in the PowerShell. So let's define a variable first that says nodes equal to XML dot select nodes. So how this will work, I will show you. Since your report is under reports, we have to traverse basically. So reports slash report and ID. So let's see how it's look slash reports. I don't want to mess up, so I will directly copy it from here. I do lot of spelling mistake actually. and let's say report. So I have to work with particular ID that says s equal to 3. So open brackets @ I have to work with ID. So ID equal to what? Test3. Again, I will copy. I mess up with words. So test3. That's done. I think this looks good. Let's see that we are at the correct one or not. Save that. Okay. And execute. Here you can see it has given us the full node here. It's a report name test3. ID equal to test3, that's correct, and color equal to green. It's not my favorite color, by the way. Okay, so now what we will do, we'll try to change the color. Here you can use for each, or you can normally use the set attribute command. So it's up to you. Basically, I will show you with the for each, it will be good for you if there are multiple reports or you have to change color of multiple nodes. So for each node, it's a variable basically in nodes means in this output. Okay, so what you have to do, I will write node equal to set attribute, and what attribute we have to work with? Color equal to, let's say, black. Yeah, you guessed it correctly, it's my favorite color. Yeah. Once you have said that, what you need to do, we also need to see that your encoding character doesn't change here. So here it's in UDF-8. So we need to figure out a way that while saving this, the encoding character does not change. So for that, you can write something like this, UTF without boom. It's a variable, nothing else. I will create a new object. I'm creating a new object that says system dot text dot encoding recipient UTF-8 encoding. I want that in UTF-8. Let's say false. Okay, that's done. Let's create another variable. I'm here saying SW, anything, you can give anything, that's up to you. Creating a new object. Okay, and the new object that I'm creating will be system dot IO input output basically dot stream writer. So it will write. Okay, so the parameter that it will take will be, first of all, it should be the path where it has to write. So I'm giving the same path so that the file name doesn't change. Encoding character false, we don't need to change the encoding character. And last, which encoding character we don't want to change, UTF-8, that's there. Once that's done, it has to write the file. Again, you can say rewrite the file. Now we need to save that because it's again written the file dot save. And what it has to save? This, because the file is there in the SW variable. That's there. Once that's done, you need to close the file. Please note that once the file is saved, you need to close the file. Close and save. So once I will execute that script, so the color here will change from green to black. So let's see. Everything seems to be correct. So let's see. And you can see here, it has been converted into black. So that was all for this video. Thanks for watching this video. In the next video, we will learn more about PowerShell. Till then, stay tuned and stay connected. And please don't forget to subscribe. I don't know you like the video or not, but I need the subscribe button to be hit. Okay. Thanks for watching.